and we have got singing, and we have got dancing, and we have got acting, and we've got special guests. But you know what that means? The show might go a little longer than normal. Do you guys think you can show me how to sit crisscross applesauce? Yeah! Can you show me ears that are ready to listen? Yeah! And maybe the most important thing, show me quiet mouths. That's amazing. Nice job. Nice job. Okay, so here's what I'm going to need you to do so that the show goes smoothly and so that we show respect to all of the people who have put in a ton of time to get this show ready for you. I need you to stay crisscross applesauce. I need you to turn on your listening ears, and I need you to keep zip the lip so you can hear all the cool stuff we're going to learn today, okay? And thank you so much for all of you community members who are here today with us, teacher or parents and grandparents and friends and all that kind of stuff. We're thrilled that you're here, but we would like to ask the same of you. Those bleachers are very, very creaky, as I'm sure you can tell, and when you move, it makes a lot more noise than what you might realize. So if you can all do us a big favor and try to stay seated and stay quiet so that we can all enjoy the show. Teachers, we may need a little extra help today because it is a longer show. So we may need your extra help today with trying to keep these guys quiet. Okay, show me that you're ready for a great show. Sit up quiet, sit up straight and tall, put your eyes up here, and enjoy the show.
Hey everybody, welcome to Zebra Zone. This is the place where you kids get to bring your parents to learn about our Zebra Zone trait. My name's Amy, this is my co-host Becky.
Hey.
Hey, really, that's all you got for them?
Well, how am I supposed to get excited about seeing these people? They come here month after month.
Becky, these kids are what's exciting. And you know, some of them aren't here month after month. See that little guy back there? I think it might be his first time.
Oh, I'm talking about the kid with the hair and the shirt.
They all have hair and shirts.
No, I don't think so. No, the one over there, he always shows up here and he has like sleep crusties in his eyes and he's wearing half of his lunch on his face.
Becky, you just might be looking in a mirror. I mean, seriously, what's up with you?
Well, my neighbors had this party last night and a sleepover for their daughter.
Well, that sounds like fun.
Oh, well, maybe for them. They had the music blaring and they were loud and they were playing flashlight tag outside. Ooh.
I think I see where this is going.
Yeah, it's going to where I only got an hour of sleep last night, so pardon me if I'm not really excited about seeing a bunch of little whippersnappers.
Sure, it wasn't these guys that kept you up last night. In fact, they're really excited about being here and learning about how they can make a difference. So I think you're just going to need to take some time to get to know them.
Yeah, well, you know what? I think I'd rather get to know my pillow.
Oh, well, how about if we try to say the virtue together and maybe that'll wake her up just a little bit. What do you think?
Yeah!
Let's
whatever.
Play our Zebra's own tray. Come on, Becky, get with it. Here we go, guys. Individuality. Discovering who you are meant to be so you can make a difference. That was pretty good.
Oh, parents, your turn. Ready? Discovering blah, blah, so you can yada, yada, different.
Becky, come on now. You're not even trying. These kids are here and they're trying to make a difference so they can change their world.
Wait. Are you telling me that these kids are all going to plan sleepovers so they can affect somebody else's sleep schedule?
No. They're going to make a difference for good.
Oh, please. Maybe by the time they're 38, they quit slurping their milk and dropping little cookie crumbs all over their computer keyboards.
No, they can make a difference for good right now, just the age that they are, can't you guys?
Oh, please. Have you ever seen a 9-year-old who's a bank manager or a golf instructor or president of the National League of Garbage Collectors?
Well, no, but you know, it doesn't take a fancy title to make a difference.
Ooh, fancy. Well, pardon and moi, my faux pas.
Oh, my goodness. I think we better take Becky to the clubhouse so she can learn a bit more about what it really means to be an individual.
Great.
Oh, that's a better attitude.
Because I can sleep till then.
Aw, let's go check out what's going on in the clubhouse.
I got an idea. You guys want to make a difference? Why don't you just start by shutting off my alarm clock?
Come on, Becky. Let's go check things out. Hey, Columbia, stand up! Let's get this party started! I know that you are happy because fall break is just around the corner. Clap your
are somebody! Are you ready?
Sugar coma! My blood sugar's slagging off the church.
Gordo, there you are.
I only toot my horn for candy corn.
Gordo.
Cause it can't even make you.
Gordo!
Hey, Grandpa.
You're nuttier than Cousin Beulah's peanut cluster.
What you doing?
Well, I was.
Where you been?
Well, I've been.
Yeah?
Well, I'm trying.
Uh-huh.
I'm trying.
Yeah.
I said.
What? Yeah.
Gordo.
Would you like some candy corn?
Maybe I should just take it all from you.
Psych!
Son, just listen. I'm just too tired to put up with your nonsense. The whole day I've been setting up that new lighting display to kick off that our fall festival thing tonight.
Oh, the new lighting system designed by Mr. Big Shot Lighting Guy.
Don't be going tripping no breaker on me, Gordo. It's the mayor's nephew, and he's studying at that school of design and electric, the school in Stubville.
Nepotism.
No, he's Methodist, I think. But anyways, it's a real big, fancy, slancy, I mean, it's real.
So now you're jumping on the replaced Gordo bandwagon.
Say what?
Well, I've heard it all before, you know. You're too young, or you don't know enough about that stuff, or go get that fire extinguisher again, Gordo. So here I am with my candy corn. Maybe when I'm really old, like 40, somebody will think I can make a difference.
Oh, you're being silly, Gordo. You have a lot to offer. Besides, you might learn something new with this newfangling wire plan. I mean, here, take a look at this diagram. It's wires, wires. I'm telling, look at this. I mean, ain't she something?
Oh, just a basic garden variety lighting schematic. Nothing to get all excited.
Oh, the crowd's gonna love it. We're gonna flip that switch and those lights are gonna go. Who is our nation is calling out? Hello? What? What do you mean those lights are? Well, I followed up. All right. I'll be there. Horse feathers.
Problems with the new lighting system?
You know, it's probably just a breaker or a fuse or maybe some wires are crossed. But I gotta go down and check it out. Why don't you come with me? It might be a two-man job.
Nah, you got your Stubville lighting design guy. What difference could I make?
All right. Well, I'll be back in a minute or two. Flabbergast! Why are they gonna go messing with those contrary lights? I'm telling you.
They designed the lights, and they put up the lights, and they fixed the lights, and all without me. Well, at least I still got you, candy corn. See, candy corn, they fixed all the lights, and without me, no problem. Hey, Grandpa. I knew you could do it without me. Is somebody burning tires?
Gordo, I just had 100,000 volts of electricity shoot through my body.
Is that you, Grandpa?
Man, I'm picking up an old classic country radio station in my feelings.
You're scaring me, Grandpa.
I got conflict with in my head. Come on, boy. You gotta help us. I need your help.
Oh, no, you didn't need me at the beginning when we were starting, and I'm sure I can't make a difference now.
I'll tell you, that candy corn is making a difference in your mental capacity. What if I just, I'm gonna take that away from you.
No.
Come here.
Individuality thing, it's a little hard to understand, isn't it? Yeah, it's not like some of the other traits that are easy to pick up, so I want you to stand. We're gonna sing together, but my friend Callie here, she's got blow down, so listen up.
Why are you leaving?
right? But it takes somebody special to figure out what their own talent is so they can make a difference. Is that what you're saying? So like Mr. Hall back there, he can do all this fancy light and sound stuff. He's making a difference, isn't he? Yeah. And like some of my friends right over here who are being respectful so that they'll spread to all the people around them. Are they making a difference back there? I think
everybody to give Gage one more big round of applause. Let me help you down, okay? Boys and girls, remember next month that could be you. Keep showing the character trait. Your name could be entered to win a bike for next month, okay? I'm very proud of all of you. You're doing an awesome job, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the show.
Like here at Columbia. You're all part of a body of Columbia zebras. But together you're individuals, and together you make a difference.
It's true. I tell you, it's true, because Aussie Possum's body, they are working together for some things that you don't even know about. Like, for instance, my nose and my feet, they do the same thing because they both smell. You know, you get it? I tell a joke. The nose, the feet, the same thing, they smell. Wow. Tough crowd. But you know, I have a demonstration for you to demonstrate my point today.
A demonstration?
Don't worry, it's very, very simple, but I will need some help with this one.
Okay.
Could I have someone please bring my other assistants out for me?
Okay.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Boys and girls, this is my friend, Justin Bieber. Baby, baby, baby. Secret, he is such a very important part of our demonstration today. You see what I did there, kids? I said part, and we're talking about the body parts, and I say, Secret parts. Wow, Secret, tough crowd today, high five. Anyway, you, ma'am, you hold this one. This is the operation game, and so I will sing a song with Secret, and I will point to the body parts, and when I point to the body parts, you will put the body parts carefully from the game. But you see, you have to be careful because inside of my lab coat here, kids, I have wired some teeny-weeny electrical shocks. So when you shock this game here, it will also shock me. So please, have a very steady hand in me.
No, I don't want to shock you, Professor.
No, please, I trust you, and we have to put these. Look at these children. We have to demonstrate the points of the body working together.
I'm not very good at this.
It's okay. Okay. Here we go. We will sing this song. The toe bone's connected to the foot bone. The foot bone's connected to the ankle bone. The ankle bone's connected to the leg bone. So shake those skeleton bones. Oh, you're doing very good. Your hand is so steady. Let's continue now. The leg bone's connected to the knee. Oh! You shot me in my hand pocket. Okay, so let's continue real quick. The knee bones connect. Okay, I haven't even said any parts yet, and you have already shot my shoulder pocket again.
I'm so sorry.
Okay, so what you need to do is just settle down. You're like a chihuahua with caffeine. So settle down, we will continue. It's okay, don't worry, I didn't even feel it too much. The leg bones connect.
There ain't nothing that can make us move from this couch. Absolutely, positive.
if it doesn't.
Gordo, save freaking popper.
Except for that.
Would you mind telling me why the microwave comes on every time Grandpa Henry just walks by it?
Mom,
and he has shocked me 3 times, and I can't even find the cat.
You don't?
You better start talking.
I'm trying to. Well, you see, I was just sitting here eating my candy corn and contemplating life.
Yeah, yeah. What? Get to the part about how you didn't go help Grandpa Henry out when he really needed you.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, I just figured nobody thought I could make a difference because, you know, I'm just a kid who likes science, and so they figured I don't know anything about life. And so they hired the mayor's big shot light designer nephew, and I just figured they didn't need me. But I...
No buts except for that one that's going to get off of that couch right now and go down there and start helping.
But Mom, you don't understand. For one thing, I'm going through this big sugar crash, and everything I do is painful. And the other thing is,
I can't believe it.
I know, I can't either. Look, he's still sitting here.
No, I can't believe the light display. They fixed it.
Dad, why are you shouting?
Oh, I'm sorry. Still had a ringing in my ears from that electrical shock earlier.
See, Gordo, your grandpa really does need your... Wait a minute. The lighting got fixed? Did you fix it?
I didn't fix it, and the mayor's nephew didn't fix it either.
Okay, so if you didn't fix it, and he didn't fix it, then how did it get fixed?
I fixed it!
Oh, please, Gordo, you have done nothing all day.
Now, let the boy finish. What do you mean, Gordo?
Well, you know, I just figured that... Nobody has to ask me to make a difference. I could just do it, so I just fixed it.
Is that the sugar talking?
I don't know. I can't hear you. There's a phone ringing.
Well, you know, I was looking at those lighting plans, and I discovered what was wrong and how I could fix it, so I just did it. And, you know, it was just a simple little matter of the cables that were routed incorrectly. And so I just took some of that stuff. And you know, normally the capacitors and the resistors can handle a load like that.
Okay.
But in this case, I
think I've heard enough, Gordo. I think I understand. I am so proud of you that you stepped in to make a difference. And I'm really sorry that I jumped to conclusions that you just sat around here all day. I know. How about I go make you some of my famous sugar cookies?
Sugar.
Somebody answer that phone!
Boys and girls, I am so glad that Gordo went down and he helped out without even being asked. I am so, so proud of him. He not only showed them that he's a kid that loves science, he showed them that he's really smart too. You know, they said he did a better job than it was done before. So now we can have the fall festival. Oh my goodness, this candy corn is so good.
Wow, well this is pretty cool to be able to fix something, and it's pretty good to be able to do the right thing and make a difference, even if I'm just a kid who likes science.
Boy, howdy, that electrical shock get my system. But the effect's nowhere off. But seriously, can somebody answer that phone?
Oh, boys and girls, Grandpa and Gordo and I, we just wanted to show you today that you can make a difference. We can all make a difference. It doesn't matter if you're a boy or if you're a girl, if you're young or if you're old like Grandpa Henry here. You might like to do math, you might like to read, maybe you're good at science like Gordo is. You might play the piano or play sports. Whatever it is that you're good at, you can use that talent and we can all make a difference. And this month, we're really celebrating our individuality to make a difference in the life of one of our little zebra friends, Niali. You guys remember Niali, don't you? Yeah. I'm going to have Mrs. Thomas come up here and she's going to tell us some of the things
that they're doing in gym class that you're doing to help Nayali. So boys and girls, I need you to be very quiet. I want you to listen to Mrs. Thomas.
Well, Mrs.
Schwank,
some of my friends. Mrs. Schwank came up with a great way that we could use PE to show Nayali and her family that we care for them and we're supporting them. And so in PE class started yesterday, all the kids are running laps to show their support. So we go all next week and they run laps around the gym, and for 10 minutes we keep track, and at the end they get a sticker that says, I ran however many laps for Nayali. And we just thought it was a great way to show all the kids that they could be a part of showing some love for their friend Nayali by using the talent, whether it's walking or running or whatever you can do, just something as simple as that, can show someone that you love them. And of course, we really wanted to show Nayali that we love her. And Ava, how many laps did you run? Actually, 24 laps.
Oh, 24. Hey, let's give you guys all a big round of applause for running super hard. You have to run that. Do your best, okay, for my colleagues. I'm going to have the Armstrong family come on up. Some of you know Gabe and Garrett. Jump up here, boys. They're doing something really special for Nayali. I want you to listen very carefully, especially you parents out there. Our family loves to bake, and our aunt owns her own restaurant. Those are talents and gifts that we have as a family that make us individuals.
We are holding a big sale tomorrow, October 13th, at Teal's in Mentone from 8 a.m. to noon to raise money for Nayali.
All right, Garrett, I'm going to ask you, this is the big question, okay? Does your mom make better sugar cookies than I do?
Yes.
Yeah! He got it! Hey, I want to try some of her sugar cookies, okay? So parents, tomorrow, if you're around, head on up to Teals and Mentone and you guys can help benefit Nayali just through buying some really good food, okay? Thank you guys very much. Give them a round of applause.
Other people in our building who have been making a difference, and that's your teachers and the staff. You guys remember, hey guys, you remember the last 2 weeks, the teachers and the staff have been wearing jeans. Did you notice them? And they've been doing that. They've been paying money each day to wear jeans so they could raise money for our friend Nayali. And you see a couple t-shirts that folks teachers have gotten. And also our parent teacher organization has given us some money. But guess what, guys? I have totals of how much we've raised, okay? You wanna hear? You wanna hear how much money we raised as of this morning?
All right.
All the schools have been working together. The middle school and the high school have raised $897. Isn't that awesome? Want to hear how much they've raised for Nayali by running? They're running just like you guys have. $2,622.25. Boys and girls, guess how much we've raised at Columbia by your running, by the gym donations. Let's hear a drum roll. Columbia Elementary has raised $2,776.58 for our friend. And boys and girls, that is a total. That's a total altogether of $6,295.83. Wonderful.
One more thing. Mrs. Lunsford, come on out.
I'm so proud of you guys for putting your talents together to make a difference. But unfortunately, it's time to say goodbye. Can you put your hands together?
Thank you.
good.